He'll have two tongues made out of fire. Then the oppressor will be on the plane of resurrection. The oppressor, this oppressor will be in such darkness. Wallahi, by Allah, the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that so much darkness he will be surrounded with, that if he was to place his hands in front of his face, he will not be able to see his own hands. In another narration, he will be made blind. And the one who gives difficulty to his neighbors, he'll be on the plane of resurrection, he will have no arms. Different people, according to their sins, will be raised on the plane of resurrection. They'll be naked, they'll be uncircumcised, they will be barefooted, and they'll be looking forward. And when this is taking place, they will remain like this for 70 years. For 70 years they will remain like this. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. The narration says that some will be sweating up to the ankles, some will be sweating up to the knees, some will be sweating up to the waist, some will be drowned in their own sweat. They will be screaming, they will be shouting, but on that day their tears will run out and blood will flow from their eyes. Fortunate is that person who finds a place to stand on the plane of resurrection. Why? Because mankind will be cramped together. And when this is taking place, for 70 years, they will remain like this. 70 years. The sun will be above their head. Could you imagine the plane of resurrection? Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. This is the plane of resurrection. Picture this in your mind. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when the whole of mankind is like this, when the whole of mankind is like this for 70 years, no hope, no nothing, they will head towards Adam alayhi salam. And they will say, Adam, intercede for us. Adam will say, the eye do not know what will happen to me. Allah is angry like never before. Go towards Nuh alayhi salam. Then the whole of mankind, they will rush towards Nuh alayhi salam. Then again, the people on the plane of resurrection will say, intercede for us. Intercede for us. Nuh alayhi salam will say, Allah the Almighty is angry like never before. I do not know what will happen to me. Go towards Ibrahim. Ibrahim, the whole of mankind will run towards Ibrahim. Ibrahim will say, Allah the Almighty is angry like never before. I do not know what will happen to me. Go towards Musa. Musa will say the same thing. Allah is angry like never before. I do not know what will happen to me. Go towards Isa alayhi salam. Then the whole of mankind will turn and they will rush towards Isa alayhi salam. And they will say, intercede for us. Isa alayhi salam will say exactly the same thing as the prophets before him. That Allah is angry like never before. I do not know what will happen to me. Go towards Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now you will realize the status of Muhammad. You will realize the true status of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The whole of mankind, could you imagine the plane of resurrection? The whole of it, they will rush towards Muhammad and they will say, oh Muhammad, intercede for us. And Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will go towards Allah and he will intercede and his intercession will be accepted. And then Allah will descend. And when the whole of mankind is on the plane of resurrection, in this manner, some will be sweating up to their knees, some up to their waist, some will be drowned in their sweat, some people's faces will be transformed into monkeys, other pigs, other people will be walking on their faces, other snakes will be around their necks and it'll be grabbing the cheeks and biting them. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the people on the plane of resurrection will be in this state. The hadith of Abu Hurairah comes to mind. Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu says that there'll be a big explosion. A big explosion will take place. Such an explosion that they will look above them. What would they see? The first heaven. It will break into pieces. And the angels will descend in their numbers. And they will encircle mankind. And they will outnumber mankind and jinnkind put together. Then the second heaven will break. And the angels of the second heaven will descend. And they will outnumber the angels before them, mankind, jinnkind put together. And they will encircle the whole of plane of resurrection. Then the third heaven will break. The angels of the third heaven will descend. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. They will descend, they will be stronger. They will be glorifying Allah. And they will encircle the whole of mankind. And they will outnumber the angels before them and mankind and jinnkind put together. The angel of the fourth, the angels of the fourth will descend. The angels of the fifth will descend. The angels of the sixth will descend. The angels of the seventh will descend. And what will happen? They will surround mankind. They will outnumber them. They will be stronger. They will be bigger. And the whole of the plane of resurrection will be lighted up. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that there's eight angels who will bring Allah's throne on that day. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that one angel that is carrying Allah's throne, his feet is on the lowest earth. And their shoulders are on the highest heaven, and Allah's throne is upon their shoulders. The distance between the earlobe and the neck is a distance of 70 years. At this moment of time, there is four angels who are carrying Allah's throne. But on the day of reckoning, on the plane of resurrection, Allahu Akbar, there will be eight angels. They'll be carrying Allah's throne. Why? Because Allah will be angry like never before. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that Allah will say to these angels, I created you for a purpose. You have fulfilled your purpose. Do you know why I created you? And the angels will reply, oh Allah, you know best. And Allah will say, I created you, that you carry my throne, you have fulfilled your purpose. Ask for any power today and I will give it to you. The first will ask, oh Allah, give me the power of the earth, and it will be given it. The second angel will ask, oh Allah, give me the power of the winds, and it will be given it. The third angel will ask, oh Allah, give me the power of the heavens, and it will be given him. And the fourth will ask, oh Allah, give me the power of the rain, of the oceans, the waters, and it will be given it. Then Allah will say, lift my throne. And they will try to lift Allah's throne. And the throne of Allah will not be able, they will not be able to lift Allah's throne. Allah will say, La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. And when they say this, Allah's throne will lift. And there'll be eight angels like this who will be carrying Allah's throne on that day. And then Allah, the Almighty, will descend in a manner befitting Allah. And when Allah descends, Allah will say, bring the fire of hell to Jibreel. And the